So we've studied the cell cycle, and we've also drawn a connection between regulation of the cell cycle and cancer and the pathology of cancer. When disruptions to the normal control of cell cycles arise by mutation or other means, then that can lead to uncontrolled proliferation and the development of a tumor. And now we're going to tackle mitosis and look at the various stages of mitosis. That is the segregation of the genetic material to two daughter poles, and then ending in cytokinesis, the separation of the cytoplasm of a parental cell into two daughter cells. So let's start out with just an overview of mitosis, looking at the movement of chromosomes in a particular cell preparation. So we're looking at a newt lung cell mitosis, and we see that the condensation of chromosomes progresses at prophase, and in prometaphase, by prometaphase, the nuclear envelope has dissolved, and the chromosomes are being put under tension as they connect to microtubules of the spindle apparatus. And that attachment of kinetochores to microtubules of the spindle apparatus is moving the chromosomes to the middle of the cell during metaphase of mitosis. And there are a few stragglers shown on the right there, over there on the right. And now they're moving into the middle as they connect to kinetochore microtubules from each pole. There's the last little straggler getting in there. And then when everything is, all kinetochores are attached and firmly, there is an anaphase signal that draws the chromosomes apart. And the chromatids separate and move to opposite poles of the cell. And then telophase is that separation. Cytokinesis is cell division. So that's a quick view of mitosis. And now we'll study that in a little more detail. So here is mitosis shown in the context of the overall cell cycle. And as we've already mentioned, there are five main phases that we divide mitosis into: prophase, prometaphase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. And we'll go through these in sequence and talk about some of the main features of the behavior of chromosomes during these various phases. And then everything, the cells divide during the blue arrow here, which is cytokinesis, in which the new daughter cells form by separation of the cytoplasm and contents into two daughter cells. So let's talk about this a little bit. But before we do, let's focus in on some main features of that you need to keep in mind. Remember that we have homologous chromosomes for every diploid cell that's dividing here. If we're considering diploid organisms. So one member of a homologous pair was inherited from a father, say, and one from the mother. And each of these, as in mitosis, will develop a kinetochore, which is an assemblage of a protein complex at the centromere of the chromosome. So centromeres are not the same as kinetochores. Kinetochores are the macromolecular assemblage, excuse me, that assembles at the centromere of a chromosome in mitosis. And the chromosomes are replicated in the S phase of mitosis. So in a way, this figure is wrong in that it shows replication occurring when the chromosomes are already condensed. That is not true. Replication of the chromosomes occurs prior to condensation of the chromosomes at mitosis. It occurs, as you know, during the S phase of the cell cycle. So here we have, even though this is incorrect in terms of the timing of replication, when the chromosomes condense at prophase of mitosis, each chromosome has been replicated, so that we see that each chromosome actually consists of two daughter chromatids. So these are sister chromatids for each homologous chromosome. And the sister chromatids are held together by cohesin proteins, or condensin proteins in animals. The cohesin proteins are replaced by condensin proteins in animals as condensation occurs. And here are our kinetochores highlighted. So that's something to keep in mind. And it is to the kinetochores that the microtubules of the spindle apparatus will attach. And they will place these chromosomes under tension, this chromatid being placed under tension to be drawn to the pole shown to the right and this one to the left. And so this is very important to consider when we talk about mitosis. And it will be the breakage or the cleavage of the cohesin proteins by another protein, the proteolytic cleavage of those cohesin proteins, which will allow the chromatids to separate at anaphase of mitosis, as we will see. And that is due to the tension that these chromatids are placed under by pulling forces exerted by the microtubule apparatus of the spindle. Let's commence then with mitosis by first considering the cell prior to mitosis, just at the end of the G2 mitosis transition. So at that point, we have replicated centrioles, and the centrioles are moving to opposite sides of the cell. That is, they will define two poles of the cell. The chromatin has already been replicated, and we don't yet see chromosomes. They will begin to condense at prophase, and they will condense rather rapidly. There is an intact nuclear membrane, and the cell is ready now for mitosis and cell division. So we have five stages of mitosis, as we've mentioned: prophase, prometaphase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. And let's tackle these in order. Prophase, we have individual condensed chromosomes, and they become visible with the light microscope. So condensation starts to occur in prophase and occurs rather rapidly. And condensation just doesn't stop at the beginning of prophase. It continues throughout the entire phase. The spindle apparatus that is organized by the centrioles as they move to opposite poles, then as they complete their migration to opposite poles, they organize the spindle apparatus by elaborating the formation of long microtubule cables. And in animals, there are several kinds of microtubules that are organized by the spindle apparatus. There are astral microtubules that occur at the poles, and there are polar microtubules, which extend from the centrioles to the center and even past the center of the cell. And then there are the kinetochore microtubules, which are the ones that attach to the kinetochores of chromosomes. And the nuclear envelope breaks down during prophase as well. So we can look at this here. We see that in prophase, the chromosomes are condensing. Here are shown highly condensed chromosomes, and there's a mistake here. And let's see if you can guess what that mistake is. That is that in this diagram, they're not showing the chromosomes as replicated, but in fact, they are replicated. Each chromosome at this phase consists of two chromatids. So there's a mistake here in this slide, and you should be able to recognize that. In fact, we list that there appears two chromatids, but we don't show it in this particular slide, so that's a mistake. The remainder of the cytoskeleton, besides the elaborating spindle apparatus, the cytoskeleton is breaking down. The Golgi and the endoplasmic reticulum are dispersed, so they're broken up and are not recognizable as intact structures. And as I've mentioned, the nuclear envelope breaks down. In prometaphase now, this occurs when the nuclear envelope has been degraded, and we know that remember that the lamin protein, which is a intermediate filament forming a meshwork underneath the nuclear envelope, lamin reorganization is involved in the disassembly of that nuclear envelope. And you'll remember we've talked about the intermediate filament protein, lamin. Microtubule attachments start to grow from the poles, and they start to attach to the kinetochores. And eventually, each sister chromatid will be connected to opposite poles of the cell. So each replicated chromosome has two chromatids, and each one will be connected to opposite poles via a microtubule, or one or two microtubules, and eventually they will be pulled apart. So the chromosomes are moved to the center of the cell as the tension on the chromatids from opposite poles equalizes, then the chromosomes will move to the center of the cell. We call this congression. And there's a constant assembly and disassembly of the microtubules. And at the kinetochores, there are motor proteins that will be involved in assembly and disassembly and movement of the kinetochores during anaphase. So this will occur. Now we can talk about, we can show a diagram of this. So we have astral microtubules here. Astral means star-like, so star-like microtubules. There are polar microtubules that can extend the length of the cell even to the middle of the cell or past the middle of the cell from each pole, and those are called polar microtubules. And then kinetochore microtubules are the ones that attach to kinetochores. And in this phase, chromosomes move to the equator of the cell in prometaphase. And then in metaphase occurs when the chromosomes align on what we would call the metaphase plate. Now this is shown schematically here. There is no plate. There's no structure that corresponds to the metaphase plate. It's just an imaginary plane of alignment that we envision in the middle of the cell. So here are the centrioles and the microtubule apparatus being elaborated by them. Here is the mitotic spindle then. And this is shown schematically here. Another view of this is here. The chromosomes now replicated have lined up independently of each other completely at the metaphase plate. Here is an example of a polar microtubule. Now anaphase. This is, we define the beginning of anaphase when the centromeres split. That is the sister chromatids split from each other. And what I'd like you to do is envision everything up to anaphase as, let's model that with our fingers. So here, let's say, is a pair of homologous chromosomes prior to replication. During the S phase of the cell cycle, replication occurs. The homologous chromosomes, each chromosome replicates. And now we have two sister chromatids for each chromosome. And in mitosis then, at metaphase, they will line up at the metaphase plate. And at anaphase, the chromatids will be pulled apart. They will split. And I want you to envision that as we'll use that to compare. We'll use our little finger models to compare mitosis with meiosis later on. Now, anaphase anaphase occurs when a signal is emanated from the kinetochores, essentially. And the key event, the end result of that signaling is the removal of cohesin proteins from the chromosomes. That is, the cohesin proteins that cause the sister chromatids to adhere to one another are completely removed, and therefore the tension on the chromatids placed by their connection or occurring because of their connection to microtubules, kinetochore microtubules, when that tension allows the pulling apart of the chromatids when the cohesin protein that's holding them together is digested. And we'll cover that in just a minute. We'll talk about that in a little more detail. And so the sister chromatids are pulled to opposite poles. Now anaphase is broken up into two stages, anaphase A and B. In anaphase A, the kinetochores are pulled towards opposite poles. So the sister chromatids are pulled apart and the kinetochores are being pulled by the assembly and disassembly of the microtubules at the kinetochore. So there's depolymerization and then reattachment, depolymerization and reattachment of the microtubules to the kinetochores. So that essentially the microtubules are being shortened, and that is dragging the chromosomes apart. And in anaphase B, the poles of the cell are actually moved apart. And that is where we'll pick up with in the next part of this lecture.